If it would have left unattended by about another month, we estimated, it would have caused one of the biggest explosions that have ever been recorded in the US at a refinery. We prevented that. And that would have not just taken down 60% of the facility's production, so millions and millions of dollars for who knows how long, but it would have killed people. It would have caused an environmental catastrophe that would have been just horrible. With robotics, you can actually gather millions, terabytes of information and data, visual, ultrasonic, LiDAR. And that's what like robots that Gecko creates and integrates does. And then you can digitally represent a world, a physical world, inside of a software platform we call Cantilever to begin to understand how do I deploy the $1 billion that I have to ensure that the bridge doesn't collapse when a mother and her kids are commuting over that bridge that day. There was 18% impact in the US alone on emissions because things just fail when they're not supposed to. If you can eliminate things failing when they're not supposed to, 18% by 2030 is the environmental impact you can have. Why aren't we all talking about that? That is something that doesn't take a investment of 10 years of new technology that may or may not exist, and it's just using robotics and artificial intelligence that we've built today. The engineering manager that was running the facility said, this power plant is shut down 40% of the year because the physical structures just fail and we don't know how to stop them from failing. And the only way to stop them from failing that they tried was sending a human that was dangling 100 feet up in the air, gathering pictures and using an ultrasonic sensor to look at the structural integrity of steel. Whoa, that's crazy. And all those sensors are such amazing technologies that gather physical world data and convert them into bits. The question is, how do you turn those bits into useful bits that drive some new efficiency at a power plant, for example, that reduces the chance of an explosion that could be horrible for the environment or for the people that are operating it and could kill them? These are the ways that I think robotics and AI will transform fundamentally our world, and we actually need them to, because we're at a place where we don't have enough humans to actually do this, because those humans, they're so incredibly skilled and most of them are retiring.
Cabo Pulmo National Park started as a small village that had depleted most of its fisheries resources. And then a group of scientists came together and worked with the community very, very thoroughly to say, how can we recover the populations of fish here in a way that will allow you to have a livelihood for the future, in a way that will recover them and allow you to do diving services? After 20 years, everything recovered 4 times what it had been before. And this is now creating almost $8 million of revenues every year from ecotourism activities. And those benefits don't have to be only monetary, right? They can be, of course, ecotourism, and they will create money from that, generate money from that, but they can also be cultural. Am I going to protect the species that I care the most about, that I want my children to interact with and to learn about? Am I going to protect the place where I grew up and that I want to see healthy? Am I going to be able to show it to other people around the world? For decades, we have focused on protecting the ocean because it is important to preserve biodiversity. And we have thought that by protecting the ocean, we can make populations of fish regrow and eventually be so big that they start spilling over. However, that doesn't work all the time. And when we try to take communities to the center of this, and we focus from the beginning on how can protection also bring prosperity, economic growth, jobs, mental health to the communities, is when we go into this concept of marine prosperity areas. It becomes a cultural value. It becomes a way to show their children how to care about things, how to be successful as a community. And eventually, there is very clear evidence that the most successful protection efforts come from communities that are on board from the beginning and that work well with the conservation outcomes.